Charmander, and we were trying to grill out some hot dogs, and there was this Jigglypuff, and she really wanted us to hear her song, and we're like, no, Jigglypuff, we're trying to play with fire here, go away, no one wants to hear you fucking sing. And she got all mad, puffed in a big air, she kicked over our barbecue, and we're like, what the fuck, man, just get the fuck out of here. So she left, right? But she came back later with like a big, like giant speaker system and tried to sing to us again. So I caught her in a Pokeball and then I had Charmander roast her alive and she died. So hey everybody, welcome to Pokemon After Dark Rye. No holds barred, no nothing podcast about Pokemon where we hurt the ones we love. My name's Brett. That's your boy, 100. Wes is also here with me. Welcome to a roadside edition of the show. Me and Wes are currently on our way back from a lovely road trip. We visited Savannah and Jacob in Cincinnati. Wes, say hi.
What's up?
Yeah, so yeah, we're recording this the day before it comes out on the road. So apologies for any things you hear in the background. Yeah, Cincinnati, Wes, what'd you think?
Oh, it's a fun town. It was nice and sunny. It stayed quite warm.
Yeah, it was way too warm. But there's not enough. Was not enough Pokestops.
Yeah, there was a complete lack of Pokestops.
We had to pay $8 to go into a park, and that was weird to me.
Yeah.
And I missed our fucking exit. Oh, the ills. The ills of. No, we'll take the next exit. Yeah, we'll definitely turn around. The ills of modern podcasting. Podcasting on the road. Damn. But yeah, that was fun. We also went to Indianapolis, but we didn't play much there. Like, the concert we went to was in a basement, and yeah, like, there wasn't much Pokemon there, but shouts out to Red Hand of Denial. Lauren Babbage, thank you so much. You're now my Pokemon friend, and I appreciate it.
Yes, thank you.
It was a great concert, great time. Got way too drunk and left myself scattered all over the Taco Bell parking lot. So, if you were in line for Taco Bell at like 1 a.m. and you saw a guy hurling into the fucking plants, that was me getting off this exit right now. Wes, what'd you catch? Anything new?
New? Not really.
No, you didn't catch anything new.
Caught a few lower end max CPs. That's about it.
Well, right now for the third anniversary of the game, which it feels like it's always been a part of our lives, which is weird, first of all, to reminisce.
You can take exit 69.
We're going to take exit 69, giggity giggity. And so the Alolan Pokemon are in the wild more frequently, and there's a chance that they could be shiny, and I got a shiny Geodude. Very happy about that. Evolved him to a Golem, 2500 plus. Pretty happy about it. We did some raids today. Shift Tree Raid. We got Savannah and Jacob back into the game, which is great.
Yep.
They need to get new phones, though. Them things were, like, holding fireballs, helping them catch stuff. But what was another one we did? Breloom?
Yeah, Breloom.
Yeah. And it was, you know, nothing to write home about. In other Pokemon news, Mudkip Day, July 21st.
Finally a good one.
Finally a good one, and it's my birthday, so that'll be great. I don't know what the shiny looks like. Wes, do you care to look that up real quick?
Yeah, we can look
it. Yeah, you look up what the shiny for Mudkip looks like, but I will be... we'll be going to the mound. And I will be Pineapple-berrying every Mudkip in sight, because I love that little thing. Probably have Hydro Cannon, just like all the other water guys. I'm pretty sure all the water guys have them. I don't know what Squirtle had, but... pretty sure there's a theme there. And also the new... what's it called, Wes? Jumpstart Research. That's out. I'm pretty sure that just ends with a Dragonite. Like, you get a Dragonite as a side effect.
So
nothing fantastic.
Kind of a purple.
Purple. Let me see. Yeah. Oh, it's so good. It's purple with some orange or gold.
So it's definitely a noticeable
difference. That's so good.
For a shiny version.
That's so good.
So, yeah,
I want it.
I think it is.
Don't skip on Mudkip.
Yeah.
That rhymes. Wes, is there any more Pokey news? Our senior correspondent. You know, we didn't really talk about Sword and Shield that much. Like, it was kind of an afterthought over the last episode. Well, there was just,
you know, they announced
we were just kind of in a hurry.
And then they went. Then they also announced that new Pokemon game, Pokemon Masters.
What is that, Wes? Help me out.
That's the Pokemon Masters is the. I haven't really read much into it, but I know it's another mobile game for the phone. For Pokemon.
Right. And pretty sure. You are playing
it's supposed to release with, you know, 400 or 500 Pokemon already from day one, I believe.
Yeah, but I think you're playing as, like, classic trainers or something. Wes, am I getting turning around on the highway or am I following this?
You're going to take a right.
Okay. Sorry about that. We're lost. Help us, Ohio. Yeah, the Sword and Shield guys love the Wolfies. Said that previously. Give me a Sword Wolf. I want it all day.
But, you know, I'm excited for the new games. I mean, a lot of people were disappointed that they're killing the Pokédex.
Oh, the National Dex, yeah. I'm not happy about it either. Like, SBJ.
Who knows? They might do what happened with Sonic, you know?
Like,
they had so much outrage.
Steve from It's Super Effective has been really adamant about why it's okay, and I love that guy, but I understand from, like, a game dev perspective why they can't do it or why they wouldn't want to do it straight out the gate. It's just disappointing. It's a bummer because almost everyone has a favorite, but you're not going to be able to get your favorite. Luckily, I saw my favorite in the trailer for Sword and Shield.
There were some generations that didn't even get one Pokemon in.
I believe that, and that's going to kind of suck. Like, I really like, you know... I hate to say it, I like some of the Ultra Beasts. I want to be able to take some of them Ultra Beast dudes in there, but I kind of doubt it.
Who knows? There might be enough outcry that they change their mind. I mean, it happened with the Sonic movie.
They could do a DLC, but I don't know. They've never really done a whole lot with DLC. So, who knows?
Yeah.
I'm sure they'll do at least some legendaries, because I doubt all the legendaries will be in the game initially, and I'm sure if they do anything, if they add any to the game later, it would be legendary, so people could carry over. Like Mew, for instance. Like, if Mew's not in the game, there deserves to be a riot somewhere outside Game Freak's door. Because Mew has to you want to carry your Mew, damn it.
Yeah.
But lots of nostalgia factor would be lost in some cases. I don't really care much about, like, the meta or bringing my awesome primal Groudon over, but just want all my dudes that I've had for freaking 2 decades to go in there.
Yeah.
It is what it is. But yes, Meowstic's in Sword and Shield already, so I'm covered.
But I do think that gives it a lot of room to work with the game. I mean, it's the first game that's not on a DS or something. It's coming on Switch. So it's good.
I'm still on the fence.
Nothing's ever perfect the first time.
I'm still on the fence whether or not I'm going to get a Switch. Like, I probably shouldn't. I don't really, like, it's against my policy to buy a console for one game.
I mean, I have a Switch, so, I mean, of course I'm going to get the game, so.
Yeah, but I can't play your Switch, so. Okay. I don't know. We'll figure it out. What else about Sword and Shield? The Dynamax thing? I think that's what it is. It's like,
yeah.
They need, like, such high-res things for Dynamaxing, like, because once they blow that 3D model of a Pokemon up, you know, it's got to look good.
Yeah, exactly.
So they really, I think what irks me about it is, like, you lost the National Dex for a gimmick. And that's one thing about, not necessarily Pokemon, but Nintendo in general, even though I know they're not developing it. But Nintendo's always pushing a gimmick, whether it's with their consoles or one of their games or something. Like, they just always doing that. It doesn't need to be gimmicky to have a good game, to be a good game. What's next, Wes?
I don't know. What is that?
You got any more thoughts on Sword and Shield?
Not really.
Have you seen any of the rumors?
No, I haven't really.
Okay, rumor time. Farfetch'd will have an evolution called Sirfetch'd.
Huh.
We're going to take a right. I see it, Wes. I saw it when you pointed at. What do you think about Sirfetch'd? Got your tongue?
I was never a big fan of him originally, so.
You shut your mouth. Filthy mouth. I think it's awesome.
I mean, he's not my favorite person.
I think it's been a long time since, like, something a Pokemon as old as a Gen 1 or got, like, an additional evolution. in a newer game, like, especially one that's never had an evolution like Farfetch. I don't know if that's even happened. I hope there's also Galar types, like the way that there was Alolan types.
Yeah.
Or Alolan forms of previous, like, it'd be really cool to see Gen 2 Galar types. I hope they kind of continue that trend. I think that'd be really sweet. Yeah. I kind of hope that there is an armored themed whatever, because that stuff's going to filter into Pokemon Go too. So if there are Galar forms, that'll definitely filter into Go, which we both love. Yeah. Anything that, any kind of cross functionality with Pokemon Go will actually be really neat. So I hope we do see those things. Wes, can you believe it's only been 11 minutes?
Yes, I can.
Where are we? There's like, oh my gosh. But we are like in the middle of a farm. No, McDonald's. Oh my gosh. McDonald's farm.
We're definitely
old McDonald's farm.
We're definitely taking a shortcut.
Oh my god. This is my fault because I was busy talking and I missed the exit. You think there's any Pokemon out here amongst these farms? What are these, tobacco plants?
I'm surprised we even have internet connection, honestly.
Yeah. No, we got nope. Anyway, let's do the purpose of this show, where we've talked about our Poke lives and skimmed over the news a little bit, which, you know, this show is not about the news. If you want a full take on the news, there's other shows that do it way, 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 way better than us, like Pokemon Go Radio, for instance. But the intended purpose of this show is every week we talk about our Poke lives. Done. Check. Check marked it right off. And the other part is we talk about a random Pokemon from the Pokédex. And here we go. And that is number 7, which is, Wes, do you care to take a guess?
You already know. 7
you already is
a starter, for sure.
From Gen 1. You already know.
And it is a Squirtle.
You saw it, yeah. It's Squirtle. Squirtle! Wes, do your best Squirtle.
Squirtle!
It's not bad, actually. Okay. I think he's got a little harshness in his voice, kind of like Bulbasaur. Like,
yeah.
Squirtle! Squirtle, yeah, say it.
No, that sounds.
Say it like you're a gangster. That, Squirtle.
That sounds a little more like. That,
Bulbasaur!
That's like Wartortle.
Wartortle!
Squirtle! I don't know.
Bastards!
I'm
Squirtle!
Not,
no, I'm you did it better. Squirtle! Squid! Squirtle! Oh, God. Okay. If you live under a rock, Squirtle is. Turtle Pokemon!
It's a water type.
What? Pure water type, baby. No secondary types.
I think everyone knows what a Squirtle is.
Yep. Abilities is Torrent. Hidden ability is Rain Dish. I don't know what that does. Excuse me. Obviously introduced in Generation 1, evolves into Wartortle level 16. We'll get to that, and which itself evolves into Blastoise starting at level 36, and we'll get to that. Wes, you don't know this because it's been a while since you've been on the show, but we've decided to cover a whole family tree when we land on a Pokemon that has multiple evolutions.
Okay.
Yes, which makes my life all. That essentially removes like 300 episodes from our catalog, but what the fuck ever. Don't even care. He's a small Pokemon that resembles a light blue turtle, and it walks on two little stubby legs. However, it can run on all fours and spin around on its shell. It's always bothered me the way Squirtle pukes water at enemies. It, like, and seeing it in Detective Pikachu, like working for the fire department, when it's spitting the water out to put the fire, it just bothers me. Like, where is that water coming from? It's essentially peeing from its mouth, and it bothers me very, very, very much. Wes, do you have any ruminations on the Squirtle?
No, I mean,
you don't got any jokes like, how are you and your girlfriend last night? I made her Squirtle.
Nah, I mean, you're all about the jokes.
Yeah. One look at the trivia here will reveal some, I think. Give me a second. Wes.
Yes.
Look up the shiny, because I don't remember.
What does the shiny Bulbasaur? I don't think he actually looks much different.
I don't think he does either. Let's see. Trivia. New released a $1 coin featuring Squirtle as part of a commemorative promotion for the Pokemon franchise. Sorry, I'm also driving. Squirtle is on one side and the nation's coat of arms on the other. That's pretty awesome. As a species, Squirtle has been trained most frequently as the Kanto starter Pokemon for major anime trainers, with Ash, May, Gary, and Tierno each owning one.
On that note, his shiny version.
That's Bulbasaur.
Oh, wow.
He actually looked at what Squirtles look like. Oh, a little grass frog. Yeah, that's what he looks like. My gosh, Wes, you had a super brain, just went brain dead for a second.
Yes, I did.
Squirtle's design is based on both its final form and baby turtles, much like Wartortle. Its tail is a reference to Japanese legends of the Minogami, a turtle which lived for 10,000 years and grew a tail made of seaweed. Wow, Wes. Oh, yeah, it's just a lighter blue. Wartortle's is a deeper purple, and Blastoise is like Wartortle, basically, a deeper purple. Not the best. Squirtle's the worst of those three. Blastoise will accept, but they also had the Squirtle Squad sunglasses in Pokemon Go for a while, even though they were the wrong glasses, but that's okay. Shinigami is a combination of money and tortoise turtle. It literally means baby pond turtle. According to Black and White television program PokeQuiz, Zenny is an old-fashioned word for money, and Squirtle's shell looks like old coins, so that's how they got their name. Folks, moving on. Wartortle. Thought it was over. It's not. We gotta do all three of these things. Miserable. Wes, you got anything to say about Wartortle? Because I do not.
Wartortle, I don't think, had too many appearances in most shows.
How much you want to bet? Major appearances, Team Wartortle, a group of Wartortles part of a firefighting squad led by Captain Aiden. I'm skipping. May's Wartortle is an episode. Tierna's Wartortle is an episode. Or they appeared in episodes. Oh my god. The Pokemon Water World, Ash's Squirtle, Squirtle Squad, the Firing Squad, Staging a Hero's Welcome, Good Friends, Great Training, Tag Team Battle Inspirations, Beach Blankout Blastoise, Judgment Day. Oh, God. The Ultimate Test. Pikachu's Vacation. Pikachu Revolts. Bye-bye, Psyduck. The Power of One. Don't you feel like a fool, Wes? Hook, Line, and Stinker. That'd be you right now. Dueling Heroes. Hi-Ho, Silver, Away. Pokemon Heroes, Latios, and Latias. Tour de Alta Marie. Gonna rule the school, disguise the limit, and he appeared in I Choose You. Wes.
Yes.
How silly do you feel now?
A little bit. I just don't have much impression of him.
Does anybody really? His design appears to be a stylized turtle, feathery tail. We've already talked about its tail. And its name is a combination of war and tortoise. Wartortle. Wartortle. There you go. Last one. We're powering through. Wes, you're going to be shocked, but this is not a giant flowering grass frog with a big tree on its back, but instead it's a giant turtle with hydro cannons on its back. Blastoise. The shellfish Pokemon, which makes zero sense because turtles are not shellfish at all. But Blastoise evolves 36. It can mega evolve into Mega Blastoise using the Blastoisenite. Great, great creativity with the names there. He is a game mascot of the Japanese and international versions of Pokemon Blue. He's also, being along with Squirtle, they're one of the most popular Pokemon in existence. Wes, do you even want to guess how many appearances he's had in the Pokemon anime?
I'm going to say 40.
Too many that I can't even imagine to read right now because I got wore out with Wartortle.
Yeah, I've Blastoise, I have more recollection of him.
He was in Detective Pikachu, though, fighting that Gengar in the underground, dogfighting arena.
Yes, he was.
And he lost to Gengar. That Gengar, by the way, was terrifying looking.
Yeah.
Like, absolutely horrifying. trivia. All this stuff is from, as always, from the Bulbapedia. Thank you so much, Bulbapedia, for your usefulness. Trivia. Blastoise shares its category with Kabuto and Kabutops. They are also known as the shellfish Pokemon, which makes more sense because they're actual shellfish and not turtles. Early concept art of a Pokemon called Carabaijo resembles Blastoise without its signature water cannons. The name may be a combination of Carapace and Caravaggio. I don't know what that means. And it is a turtle mixed with aspects of a tank. Its mega form looks pretty sweet. He gets one giant cannon that no creature on the face of the earth would actually be able to carry, but I digress.
Or shoot.
Where does the water come from, Wes? Does the water come from? He's blasting you with Blastoise pee.
He has a black hole in his stomach. That just works.
Singularity.
Where it stores it all.
Quasar. No, it's pee. It's all pee. Wait a minute. Wouldn't they be severely dehydrated if they shot all their water off like that?
Yeah. I mean, he's got like a little storage dimension where all the water
comes from. A pocket dimension where the water comes from. Yeah. Using Transformer rules.
Yeah.
Folks, we did it. That's a show right there. That's how you do it. I hope you enjoyed listening to us drive across America, this glorious flat land of Ohio. Ohio, thank you for having us. Red Handed and Al, Seraphim and Hollowfront and all those bands we saw in Indianapolis two nights ago. Thanks for that awesome time. See you later. Savannah and Jacob, thank you for housing us in your home for a few days. Wes, thank you for putting up with this stuff, and thank you for providing me hours of entertainment with things like thinking a Bulbasaur is a Squirtle. You got any final things you want to get off your chest?
I think we covered a lot of it. I mean,
we sure did. We did it, folks. That's it. See you next time, two Mondays from now, just like always. I think, is that after Community Day? Look it up on your calendar real
quick.
What's that? The next Community Day. Is it going to happen? When is the
21st?
No, I know, but what is 2 weeks from now?
Well, 2 weeks from now would be... No, that would be before.
That would be so before. So we got one more episode before Community Day strikes. Okay. Hope you all caught a shiny Raikou yesterday. We didn't. We're gone. This has been Pokemon After Dark Rai. We're not going to rap on the outro this time. Just kidding. Squirtle is gonna give me trouble, and we're gonna get down in his brown when he scorches all around town. And that's what I'm gonna say. Hey, Squirtle's got that shell back for days.